Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. The August 21st eclipse across America generated interest and excitement far and wide. Our coverage of the historic eclipse, the first coast-to-coast total solar eclipse for the U.S. in 99 years, was widespread. Anchored from the College of Charleston in South Carolina, we showed you views of the eclipse that only NASA could. Views from aircraft, like these seen from onboard our Gulfstream 3 jet by Acting Administrator Robert Lightfoot and Associate Administrator for Science Thomas Zurbuchen.
See the ring around it?
Yeah.
That's a silver ring.
So cool.
And from the ground, with expert observation and analysis provided from many of the 14 states around the country situated along the path of totality. That's where thousands of people flocked for the ultimate eclipse experience. Total darkness in the middle of the day.
It's almost there!
I can only imagine in ancient times what this must have been like.
I know.
Out of nowhere. I am covered in head to toe in goosebumps.
Let the guys at home have a few moments to take in the sights and sounds of the crowd as totality happens on the prairie.
And in our nation's capital, Vice President Mike Pence hosted an eclipse viewing at the U.S. Naval Observatory for several Washington area students. And first daughter Ivanka Trump attended a public eclipse event at the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum. The 2017 class of astronaut candidates observed the eclipse, and the astronauts aboard the International Space Station viewed it as well.
It was amazing and it was cool to see from this vantage point. So awesome sauce times three.
The next total solar eclipse in the U.S. occurs in April 2024. Until then, there's still plenty of imagery to see from the 2017 eclipse across America online at nasa.gov. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at www.nasa.gov.